Welcome back to another video of the Customs. And as you guys can see behind me right here, me and Jody, well, we came back stronger than ever. For some reason, like, Jody just like ended up like buying a 180i, well, also in silver. I mean, like, we didn't know that he was gonna buy 180i in silver. I didn't know as well. The ad just popped up and then Jody just jumped for the car, and then, well, here you guys can see the car. And like by accident as well, I swapped my Conquest for this Honda. So now we're both actually rolling with new spec silver bullets. Mine is unfortunately a 150i, Jody's is a 180i. Well, but a very good purchase for that 180i of Jody. Well, we're gonna give you guys a nice walk around on the 180i as well, and then we're gonna give the 150i a nice service. And I actually bought the 150i at the grill, so we'll just be fitting the other grill on the car as well. Here before me we have the 180i. Just one thing I want to mention real quick, or ask, if any of you guys maybe have a new spec grill with the big patch on, comment down below and hit me up on Instagram, because I'm actually looking for this specific grill. I bought me a grill but with the smaller patch on. But here we have the 180i. Jody's definitely gonna replace the headlights because he likes a very like clear and beautiful lens. Obviously gonna replace the lip as well. That is a pre-loaded lip on the car, but Jody's just gonna, well, freshen up the entire front end. Obviously still need to go for roadworthy as well as for like registration for the car. The car has 180e wheels on, but Jody's definitely gonna fit a tech wheel or spoon or something on this car. Very, very nice car. Interior, it has a leather interior. Hi, Mr. Taiwan.
Yo.
Leather interior. Beautiful mileage, 208 on the clock. The car smells lovely on like the interior, and the car is just like a very beautiful car. Well, interior and exterior. But here at the back we have two grills. Well, one of these grills are for Dimitri and Dominique, and the other one in the box is my grill. But the seats in this car looks amazing. And here at the back we have, well, guys already know it's a Bullard. It's actually a 180, as you guys could like see in the previous cinematics. This car actually had the VTEC sticker on. Tyron just removed the VTEC sticker and just like placed it on my car. Well, very, very skew. But we're gonna remove the sticker there. We're gonna place the 180i sticker here. Shout out to Carl Adams, because our Carl Adams actually gave us a sticker for free. So big shout out to Carl Adams. He has a YouTube channel of his own, RaceBreed. I'll link his video right here in the corner down below and description down below as well. Carl has a nice Powerflow exhaust on as well. As guys can see right there. Well, amazing exhaust. And Jody might just install his VTEC exhaust on this car. Not completely sure, but I actually like the sound of this car. The car has a slight tint to it as well. Very beautiful. And you guys can like, well, you guys can see the tint. I'm sure it's like a 80% tint, I think. But the car in general is a very lovely car. And Jody's actually very, very glad for this new spec steering wheel, because this is the airbag steering wheel. His previous 180i didn't have the steering wheel in, and Jody has been looking for the steering wheel like since forever, I'm not gonna lie. And guys can see right there, well, let me just get this focus, 10 or 208 on the clock. And this car is just very, very neat. For some reason, like on the back window, like if you push it down, well, the window doesn't go down. But if you lift it up, you can see here, the window actually goes down. But if you push it down, then the window actually goes up. So I'm sure that switch there is like, well, reversed up, but we're gonna sort that everything out. Very, very clean engine body, like for a car we just purchased. And Jody's most probably gonna display the valve cover. The car already has some noise boys headers on, or more known as a branch. Already have like a nice cold air induction, or well, a long ram induction, not a cold air, sorry, with a nice filter as well. Jody's probably gonna run a cold air on this car as well. Well, one, it is a little bit dirty, but we can clean it up with some nice blocks in the greaser. But like in general, this car is just like a very beautiful car. And well, if you guys didn't know this, these 180i's didn't come out with these engine brace bars So the previous owner must probably just fit it this on this car, and that's the reason why like the hardware on this brace or on this brace actually looks different to like the hardware on my VTEC, because they didn't actually come out with this brace. But we most probably gonna spray this black because I don't like the red effect, and I don't think Jody likes the red effect of this brace as well. But this engine bay is hella sweet and hella neat, and like for a B-series engine, this engine bay is, I'm talking about dry. You don't even see like an oil leak anyway, and I mean like that's very neat for a B-series engine.
There you guys have your walk around on the B18 of Jody. Well, congratulations Jody with your new car. Jody was actually sad to see his other B18 go, but now he actually has, well, I wouldn't say a better car, but Jody's gonna try to make this car better, well, in the previous one, or very similar, yeah, to everything he did to that car, this car as well. But now we have the 150i here, and one thing I can actually say about this car is that this car actually pulls hard. The car actually has an engine swap in. I actually didn't notice that when I actually got the car, but I'm actually glad, because now it makes sense that there's an EG head on, and I checked out the block as well, the block like number, like the engine number, and it's like an EG block as well. So I'm actually very, very like happy about that, because I know it's not like a, like example, like a new spec below 150i block with an EG head. It's a complete EG engine, and this car actually pulls very, very hard. I mean like the car pulls quite nice. I'm gonna take you guys for test drive a little bit later, but now
we can actually just focus on the grill. This grill is actually for sale. I have a buy for the grill, which is Rudin. He's gonna display the entire grill black, but if he disappoints me, the grill then will be for sale. I'm also looking for a pre-built lip to fit in this car, but I'm gonna fit the other grill real quick. I bought some spark plugs for the car, oil and oil filter, because I just felt like to replace those on this car. Car has a slight tepid noise, not really worried about that, but the oil is black, so I definitely feel to replace the oil in this car. And one thing I actually didn't mention is that I replaced the 165/45 tires. Those tires are for sale. I might have a buyer to come collect them a little bit later, but if I still do have them, hit me up on Instagram to ask me if I still have them by tomorrow or whenever, then I'll reply to you guys to say if I actually sold them or not. But luckily I got two Continental tires in front and two Continental tires at the back. It's actually 1 and 5/50 15-inch tires, and I didn't buy these tires as a set. I bought them like one pair here and one pair there. I bought the front tires by my friend Ryan Mentor, and I bought the rear tires by another friend of Jody. So now I actually have a full set of Continentals on the car. Yeah, I have the service kit for the Honda. So I went with the 15W40 Helix shower oil. Well, I always buy this oil specifically like for my Golf as well as for this car. So I bought me the oil for the 1500, bought me some spark plugs, bought me the oil filter. I always recommend buying oil filter at Honda, but I didn't feel like driving to Honda, so I will just put it on for now, and eventually like in the future I'll drive to Honda to buy a Honda oil filter, and I most probably will replace it then. And yeah, me and Jody actually bought ourselves some indicator lights, because my indicator lights are not working for some reason. So I definitely need to replace like the holder of the bulb as well as the bulb. So me and Jody, we're gonna both replace our front indicator bulbs.
I'll definitely let you guys know if the tires are sold or not. But I think it will be sold, because the guy clearly stated he will take the tires and he might just come collect them later today. But I'm just gonna pull out the VTEC real quick, pull in the 150i, remove the grill, give the car a nice service. Then we'll be done. I guess not gonna do much today. Some basic maintenance, and maintenance is very key on like a car, especially like when you buy a car. So Jody's gonna follow these simple steps as well, like cleaning the engine bay and servicing the car and antifreeze and stuff like that, because Hondas usually have overheating problems. So you should keep your eye like on the thermostat, radiator cap, and antifreeze and stuff like that. So that's the reason why I actually did that first. Now I'm actually gonna do a service, because I just like my cars being fresh, and I don't like feel like to replace an engine just because, the oil was a little bit too thin.
Righto!
Who's here?
Guys, we're gonna take Jody's car for a test drive. He's 180. Jody, when did you buy this car yesterday?
Yesterday,
So we bought the car yesterday. Yes, oh Bola! Bola's team there, Bola.
Guys, this is not games.
Kom maar, kom.
This thing is nappy, eh?
This is no Hunger Games.
This thing is nappy.
Yo,
I must keep this camera steady, man. Who's why? Yo, the score is slapping here. This guy's nippy, guys. This guy's nippy. Nah, it pulls way better than you than your previous one.
Kano, like this is for keeps, me bro.
Is it?
Really for keeps, me bro.
Nah.
Pulls, me bro.
Didn't take me bro.
Have a good response. Nippy, yeah. Good is it?
I literally just finished servicing the car. Unfortunately, the camera actually died, so I took like a few cinematics on my phone. And while the time the battery was completely charged of the camera, I was actually really like done servicing the car. So the only thing I actually did was like drain the oil, change the oil filter, and change the spark plugs. Those were the only things I actually did to the car. And I obviously changed like the grill of the car, as you guys can see right here. As you guys can see right here, actually changed the grill. And this grill actually looks way better than the old grill. I actually really got a buy for the grill, so Jody went to go drop off that grill at Routines. But damn, it really finished off the front end of the car beautifully. I'm obviously gonna change like this lip to a Prelude lip, and I might change the wheels as well. Like, I like the wheels on the car, but it's not the look I actually want to go with the car. So I think I might just be looking for a set of VTEC wheels. So if any of you guys maybe have VTEC wheels for sale or want to swap, we can do a swap. And if you guys actually check here, I actually only have like 3 nuts on. Reason being is because this one right there, let me just get the focus in real quick. Guys can see that there, it's actually spoiled. So, well, that's really badly spoiled. So, definitely need to sort out that in the future. But for now, I think it's still completely fine. The car in general is like still completely fine. I might give the car a nice polish tomorrow, but one thing I really want to sort out in this car is like the radio, because for some reason like the radio in the car is not playing. Like, it goes on, everything works, but it doesn't send any like sound to the speakers. As you guys know, I actually removed like my sub and my monoblock from the Toyota or the Conquest. So I will be fitting the subwoofer with the box and the monoblock in this car. Here is actually a bass controller in. I'm not sure if it's gonna work with my monoblock, but I'm gonna try it out tomorrow. Sort out like a few like, well, speakers and stuff in the car, because the car actually has 6.9 in at the back. I'm not sure if it has door speakers in. I still need to check for that. But hopefully there's everything in, and then I can get the car sorted tomorrow, because I really want to be able to daily this car. And I have no idea why the exhaust is so loud in this car, but Darren really gave me a box for the car, but I definitely need want my box to actually like complete like the exhaust setup on this car.
Light!
Yes, meneer! So I just need to like get like another middle box or at least a rear box to complete like the exhaust setup on the car, and then from there we will be sorted with the exhaust on this car. I'm not sure about Jody because Jody has the exhaust laying around at his house, but he might just use it on his new car. And if he uses it on, his new car, he will be selling me his old setup. So, well, I'm still waiting on him. But while I'm waiting for him, I'm still asking around for some boxes.
If you guys love this look, don't forget to leave a like on this video, because I mean, like, I'm actually super glad I actually swapped the toy for this car. And here we actually have all three of my cars like on the same yard. We have the VTEC, we have the 150i, and we have the yellow thing. I actually still want to take you guys for a test drive in this car. Me and Tara, we're just gonna clean up and then we can actually take you guys for a test drive in this car. But this far, this car drives amazing. One thing I can actually say about the car, like driving with the car, whenever you drive with the car, like the short shift like vibrates and it gives like a weird sound. So I'm gonna try to tighten everything up there and hopefully that will solve that problem. But this car definitely pulls hard for a 1500, hands down. While cleaning up, I think I might just remove this sticker right there, this sticker right here, and that one on the other side, so I can actually get the stickers off. And I'm not sure if Tyler removed the VTEC sticker. Well, if you're gonna remove this as well, because he just pasted this on just for the fun of it, people might just think it's a VTEC, but it actually is not a VTEC. Well, yeah, guys, can't wait for the other thing to actually come back. I know you guys have been requesting some content for this car, but yeah, you guys can actually see, well, car still looks hella sweet. Guys, so the car drives quite fine. I mean, like, I adjusted the coils a bit lower now due to I fitted the 1M5 tires, so when they fitted the tires by quick fit, I just adjusted like the coilovers a little bit lower, because I adjusted it higher in the previous video due to the tires were so thin. So when I fitted the thicker tires, I actually, well, lowered the car a little bit. But I'm gonna lift the car again up and slide the coil a bit deeper into the fork. But this car actually feels quite fine. It's almost like a mini lift though. As you guys can hear, like, the one indicator is still giving a problem on that side. It worked perfectly fine, but it's giving a problem again. So I have to fix it.
Guys,
that'd
be nice.
It's just this short shift that's rattling like that. Like, if I keep my hand on it, it's like quiet, but like, yeah, it's rattling like, yeah. But the car feels freaking good. You smell like the, new oil. And then, guys, the petrol is going up tomorrow. Tomorrow's Wednesday. So I'm definitely gonna throw a little bit of petrol in here. I threw a 200 rand in the car's half, so I'm gonna throw like another 300 rand in, so the car will be full then. I'm sorted. Like, if I keep my feet like on the accelerator pedal, fifth gear, then the exhaust is quite soft. But if I let it go, and if I keep it on, soft, let go. It's fucking loud, man. Fourth gear sounds quite loud as well. But for the fifth, it's moving like that. Okay, but what is that? What is that change like though?
Fresh.
What?
The coast is clear.
Thank you.